need to breed drives all life across the wilds of Thailand. The pursuit of a perfect partner pushes animals to their limits. But getting a mate is just the first step. Bringing up baby takes commitment and hard work. Parents must keep them safe from danger, find them enough to eat, and teach them the skills they'll need to survive. Life is tough for all those playing the mating game. It's monsoon season in Thailand. The return of the rains brings fresh life. Flushes green and verdant. Thousands of birds flock to the rejuvenated wetlands where there's now lots to eat. But the rains signal more than just plentiful food. For saurus cranes, they're a sign that it's time to mate. New couples want their chick to hatch while the wetlands are still full of edible goodies. So there's no time to lose. They call in unison. The duet carries several kilometers, letting everyone know that this patch of land is theirs. Saurus cranes are the tallest flying birds in the world. Their giant wings span 2.5 meters. And they're going to need them today, but not for flying. Instead, this wetland is about to become an avian dance floor. Bowing, bobbing, and leaping. The lovebirds perform a series of elaborate moves to strengthen their bonds. The male even throws grass in an attempt to impress his dancing queen. It's a courtship ritual they'll repeat over and over again, for as long as they live. But not every crane is able to take part. This female has a damaged leg. There'll be no dancing for her this season. And if she can't dance, she can't find a mate. She may have a lonely few months ahead. But for this happy couple, the magic of the dance seems to have worked. There's a darker side to the mating game for some living on Thailand's wild side. In the mixed forests in the north, Assamese macaques are on the move. The troop is made up of both sexes. Females stay with the group into which they were born. But males are less tied to their family units. They leave to join other troops, allowing them to spread their genes far and wide and avoid inbreeding. When a female is ready to mate, it affects all the males. Testosterone levels rocket as competition intensifies and tempers can flare. Aggressive males unsettle the whole troop. A young upstart has pushed his luck too far. It seems that he edged a little too close to a female, and the dominant male put him in his place. Meters is a long drop from the treetops. He's lucky to be alive. But he's severely injured and still in grave danger. On the forest floor, he's vulnerable to predators. There's nothing the rest of the group can do to help him. He needs to get himself back to the safety of the trees before darkness falls. His attempt to mate ended badly this time, but if he survives, he'll get another chance in the future. Getting rid of the competition is one way to ensure the best access to a mate. And some like to bring out the big guns in an attempt to come out on top. As the tide retreats, the beaches of Thailand fill up. Male fiddler crabs emerge from their burrows and start to feed, shoveling in sand with one small claw, filtering out microscopic titbits and dumping the waste in tiny balls that litter the beach. But it's their other super-sized claw that gets all the attention. And it's time to put it to good use. Space for a burrow is much sought after on this crowded beach. These underground holes are used for mating and egg laying. No burrow, no winning over a female. So those without a subterranean hideaway must be prepared to fight for one. And a big claw is the perfect weapon. One homeless crab is ready for a duel. He ambushes another male as he emerges from his hole. The stakes are high. If it gets violent, they risk losing their precious claws. The aggressor presses his advantage, forcing the current homeowner to retreat. He's now the proud new proprietor of an all-important den. He just needs a mate to fill it. There are a number of females around. Time to put the oversized appendage into action again. Waving it frantically, this male attempts to attract a mate. But no one is taking any notice. All he can do is keep trying. Across the wilds of Thailand, looking good to win over a potential partner is part and parcel of the mating game. And one animal has got dressing to impress, down to a fine art. It's first light in the protected forests to the west of the country. A green peacock stirs from his roost and makes his way to an open patch of land. A sandbar near a small river. There's lots of room and plenty of sun. It's the perfect spot. The arrival of the peahens is what he's waiting for. Now is the moment to wow them. He unfurls his train, which is more than 1.5 meters long. Rattling his wings, the iridescent feathers catch the sunlight for maximum effect. This is the key to his mating success. Females favor males with the most elaborate trains and the highest number of eye spots. It's believed to indicate the healthiest males with the best genes, something any mother wants to pass on to her offspring. Not everyone appears impressed, but he's undeterred. Another female seems more interested. His luck might be about to change. And in less than a month, the peahen bears the fruits of their labor. If you're not an exhibitionist, then you have to rely on other tactics to get yourself noticed. A deafening sound emanates from deep in the forest. The tiny musician isn't obvious at first. He's well camouflaged against tree bark to avoid sharp-eyed predators. Cicadas are one of the noisiest insects on the planet. And this male is singing to attract a mate. Only the males sing, flexing drum-like organs called timbals in their abdomens to make their ear-piercing mating call. Each species of cicada has a unique sound, ensuring that males only attract females of their own kind. But mating success is a double-edged sword. His life's mission complete, he'll die soon after. Every creature has its own way of attracting a mate. For some, pheromones can help to seal the deal. In the grasslands of wild Thailand, a small herd of sambar deer gathers to graze. But they're not just here for the food. Rubbing his face on a nearby tree, a male scent marks his territory, a sign he's ready to mate. Scent marking is key for all deer. They use it to communicate and have multiple scent-producing glands on their bodies. Some under the eyes, others in the feet. And sambar deer have an extra gland located on their necks. Both sexes have it. And in males, it's thought to ooze a secretion during the rut. Sambar deer also have a way to decipher hormonal calling cards. Curling back his top lip, a male inhales the air over a special scent-detecting organ in the roof of his mouth. This strange maneuver is called the Flamen's response. And he's onto something. The pheromones reveal that this female is ready to mate. All he needs to do now is stay close and wait for the right moment to make his move. Sharing the grasslands are herds of hog deer. Much smaller in size and weight than their sambar cousins. They might be slight, but they're just as adept at using scent to play the mating game. Stamping his foot, one male spots a rival. Breeding season is just 3 short months. With so many females here, he wants to secure access to as many as possible. Pawing at the ground ups the ante. But then, this male does something bizarre. He urinates in his own face. It's not as strange as it may first appear. Urine can be used to communicate a male is ready to mate. But it's not always enough to win over the females. The males are persistent. But if she still shows no interest, across Thailand's wild places, it's a challenge for animals to find their perfect partner. And once they've found them, some hold on tight. The Gulf of Thailand is home to hundreds and thousands of birds. But every year in late spring and early summer, they're joined by strange creatures from the deep. Known as living fossils, horseshoe crabs have barely changed in almost 500 million years. The adults migrate from the ocean depths to these coastal beaches to mate. Once the male has found a female, he clings on with an extra set of claws until she swims to the nesting beach, where he'll fertilize her eggs. There's another animal on Thailand's wild side that also won't let go of its mate easily. In the rainforest, it can rain any day of the year. But during the wet season, it pours down in bucketfuls. And one animal in particular has been waiting for this moment to make its presence known. As darkness falls, male frogs begin their nightly chorus. There are 60 different species here, and it's the rain that's triggered their frenzied calling. Frogs need to lay their eggs in bodies of fresh water, so they're desperate to attract a mate while there's plenty of watery real estate to choose from. A vocal sac acts as an inflatable amplifier to announce their location to any nearby females. She gets to choose who she wants to mate with, judging his quality based on his call. And males across the rainforest seem to be hitting their mark. He climbs on her back and holds on tight. Special pads on his front legs helping him to grasp her firmly. Hidden in the murky depths, they're in for the long haul. They could remain in their lover's embrace for hours or even days. As she lays her eggs, he releases sperm to fertilize them. The eggs are then surrounded by a foam nest to keep them safe and moist. And it won't be long before those that survive emerge as tadpoles. For the animals of wild Thailand, finding a mate is rarely easy. And some go to elaborate lengths to court a prospective partner. In a wetland, amongst the reeds, Asian golden weavers are getting busy. A blade of grass is all a male needs to begin building one of the most intricate nests in the bird kingdom. With his feet bridging the gap, he uses the grass to lash together two strong reeds to form the basis of the nest. It's a good start. But now the real work begins. He cuts grass and reeds with his conical beak. And over the course of several days, painstakingly brings hundreds of bits and bobs to add to his masterpiece. It's a real labor of love. All with one objective in mind: to impress a female. She inspects the nest to see if it's up to standard. If it's not, he'll have to start all over again. Most don't meet with the female's approval and are never completed. A male may start 30 in a single breeding season. This one seems to have passed muster. The successful male can now add the finishing touches. A few weeks later, the female is doing her share of the work, bringing food to feed their tiny chick. The nest has a narrow, downward-facing entrance to make it harder for predators to get in. For added security, it's built high off the ground. And it's just as well. A python is on the lookout for a meal. But out of reach, the chick is safe. Building a home is high on the list of priorities for many parents to be. Right across the wetlands, a whole host of birds turn construction worker. This is no time to be fussy about your neighbors. Different species share the same trees. Right in the thick of it are black-crowned night herons. They use their binocular eyesight for hunting fish. But this time, hunting sticks is the name of the game. Still a few more to find before the nest is complete. Across Thailand, choosing a safe spot to keep your offspring out of harm's way is one of the first challenges for new parents. But some nurseries leave a lot to be desired. Black-winged stilts nest on the ground, where their eggs are vulnerable. To make matters worse, this pair has picked an area of wetland frequented by cattle and water buffalo. And Dad isn't happy about his home turf being invaded. His frenzied calls ring out as a warning. And his nest-sitting partner tries to help him out. Leaping up and down, flapping her wings, she does everything she can to attract the buffalo's attention away from her nest. The egg's patterned shells help to keep them camouflaged. But it's a poor line of defense against 1,000 kilos of buffalo. The Goliaths take no notice of the pair's antics. Mom returns to the nest in an attempt to guard her precious cargo. Eventually, the herd moves on. A lucky escape. Being a good parent is key to bringing up offspring successfully. You have to be prepared to go above and beyond to give them the best start in life. To teach them all the things they need to know in order to survive. And one of Thailand's most charismatic creatures is set up better than most to do just that. Asian elephants go the extra mile for their calves before they're even born. They have a longer pregnancy than any other mammal, almost 22 months. And when their babies are finally born, they're under the protective guidance of the matriarch, for the first few years of their lives. She's the head of the clan, and she knows which of the grassland trails lead to the best places to eat, the best places to drink. She was shown the way by her elders, and now it's her turn to pass on that knowledge to her children and grandchildren. Wisdom passed down the generations. She successfully guides her family to the nearest watering hole. Adult Asian elephants need to drink nearly 200 liters a day. So knowing where water holes are is a crucial skill all elephants need. Smaller members can't wait to plunge in. More interested in using their trunks as snorkels than drinking straws. These watering holes play another important role for the herd. In the heat of the day, they're vital for helping them cool down. Before they move on, there's one more thing the little ones need to be shown. Right beside the pool is a bare patch of soil. Elephant hides may look tough, but they're prone to sunburn. Dust acts as a sunscreen, and it sticks nicely to wet skin. The youngsters catch on quickly. They're learning how to protect themselves. Sunblock applied, it's time to get back to the business of feeding. The forests of Thailand can be dangerous places. So a support network can be crucial to bringing up baby. Being part of a group means more eyes and ears on the lookout for danger. It's a vital security blanket for mothers who are looking after the young ones. But keeping the wider family together isn't always easy. Assamese macaques in Thailand's northeastern forests put a lot of time and effort into staying close. They constantly reinforce their bonds through grooming. There's no age restriction. Old and young get the special treatment. Has the added bonus of removing parasites, keeping everyone fit and well. But it's not all happy families for primates in these forests. High up in the canopy, a troop of dusky leaf monkeys wakes up. They spend almost all their time in the trees, having no need to come down to the ground for either food or water. The adults have dark coats, but a bright flash of orange in the greenery reveals the presence of a young baby. The babies will stay like this until they're around 6 months old. Their bright coloration is thought to help mums pick them out in the dense foliage. But it also means they're easy for others to spot. Another member of the troop who doesn't have a baby wants to have a hold. There's a tug of war. But the little one has no intention of letting mum go. No one else is going to get a cuddle today. It's early morning in the mixed forests. A group of wild boar sows and their countless piglets are on the move. Mothers and babies stick together. But the fathers are nowhere to be seen. Male wild boars are simply sperm donors. Once the deed is done, they go back to their lives of solitude and take no further part in the piglet's upbringing. But not everyone here shirks their responsibilities. And one faithful father doesn't cut any corners. These rainforests are home to huge flocks of great hornbills. They tend to pair up for life, each couple working together to share the burden of bringing up chicks. First things first, find a safe spot for mum to lay her eggs. There are some specific requirements. It needs to be a large natural cavity high up in a tree. And this one fits the bill. The mum-to-be starts to spring clean the entrance. She wants it to be spotless before she lays her eggs. Once inside, a female uses feces to seal the entrance, except for a small gap at the top. She won't leave the nest for several weeks, so it's over to Dad to bring enough food to keep his partner going. It's no mean feat. He cares for her until the chick hatches. Then his workload increases. There's now more than one hungry mouth to feed. It's a relentless to and fro. Only once the chick is bigger can mum come out to help. And a brief glimpse of fluff proves it's all been worth it. In the wetlands of Thailand, busy parents must deal with the demands of their needy newborns. It's been over a month since they mated, and a pair of Saras cranes has two additions to the family. Since they nest on the ground, their small chicks are extremely vulnerable to predators. So they need to be able to stand on their own two feet and fast. Their doting parents feed them up and they grow bigger and less helpless by the hour. Others aren't quite so mobile yet. High up in the trees, cattle egrets won't fledge until they're nearly 2 months old. So there's no rest for hard-working parents who must try to keep up with their insatiable appetites. There's no love lost between siblings. Each vies for prime position when mom and dad return. First in line gets the food. Left alone, they continue the fight. And it can be to the death. The victor will now have the undivided attention of its parents, and its chances of making it to adulthood have gone up. Other babies across the wilds of Thailand get on much better. For Assamese macaques living in large troops, there are always plenty of playmates. There's a fair bit of rough and tumble, but it rarely gets out of hand. Their climbing frames are the trees of the forest. But other primate babies are just as relaxed amongst the bricks and mortar of an urban jungle. The long-tailed macaques of Lop Buri, a city just north of Bangkok, have it easy. They never need to search for things to eat. Many locals believe them to be disciples of a Hindu god. So twice a day, they bring more than enough food to please everybody. And the Prang Samyot temple, where a large group has set up base, has plenty of water too. So there's ample time for the young ones to get up to mischief. Their play also helps prepare them for adulthood. It improves their strength. Coordination. And dexterity. All with a watery safety net underneath. And under the watchful eye of one of the troop's elders. Those who play the mating game across the wild places of Thailand face many challenges. Attracting a partner, building a home, and raising offspring. It's a demanding journey with many pitfalls along the way. Those who succeed ensure their descendants survive to bring up their own families on Thailand's wild side.